Welcome. From the last videos, we are learning about the mechanism of emergence of the antibiotic resistance. In that, we have learned that there are the two types of the mechanisms, and that two mechanisms, it is the genetic basis, and yes, it is second one, it is the mechanistic basis. Okay, these are the two types of the mechanisms. In that, we are at the point and it is the genetic basis. In the genetic basis, we are learning about the horizontal gene transfer. In the horizontal gene transfer, we have learned about the integrons. And in the integrons, we have seen that what is the structure of the integrons, how they are going to spread, which are the classes of the integrons. And now, today's video, it is concerned about the plasmids. What is the plasmid? Yes, plasmid, it is the extra chromosomal genetic element. And this extra chromosomal genetic element, it bears the number of genes, and that genes, they may or may not be essential for the bacterial cell. One of the gene in which we are interested, that it is the antibiotic resistant gene. This antibiotic resistant gene, most of the time they are present over whom? They are present over the plasmids. And these plasmids, we know that they are going to be transferred from one bacterial cell to the another bacterial cell, and the process by which it is going to be transferred from the donor bacteria to the recipient bacteria, that process, it is called as the conjugation. So, by the process of the conjugation, that is by the direct contact of the two bacterial cell to each other with the help of the pili, the plasmids, it is going to be transferred from one bacterial cell to the another bacterial cell. And if that plasmid, it is bearing the antibiotic resistant gene, the recipient bacteria, now it is going to be a antibiotic resistant. So in this way, the plasmids, it is going to play the role of, okay, it is going to play the role in the spread of the antibiotic resistance. Okay, now here, which are the antibiotic resistant genes? The genes like the beta-lactamase genes, okay, that is your BLA or the COX, okay, these are the some of the genes, or the genes which are giving the resistance for the amyloglycosides, that genes, they are located where? They are located over the plasmids. And these plasmids, it is going to be transferred to the recipient bacterial cell, and the recipient bacterial cell, now it is gaining the resistance for the antibiotic. Now, when there is the presence of the antibiotic into the medium or into the environment, this spread, it is going to be a faster one, because the bacterial cell, it has to survive into that environment. But what is going to happen when there is no presence of the antibiotic into the environment? Does this antibiotic resistant gene, it is going to be eliminated by the bacterial cell, or the plasmids, they are going to be eliminated, or what is going to happen to the bacteria when there is no presence of the antibiotic into the environment? At that time, the bacterial cell which are bearing the plasmids, okay, the bacteria which are bearing the plasmids with the antibiotic resistant gene, it has to give the cost, and that cost, it is called as the fitness cost. What it is called? Yes, it is called as the fitness cost. That is, the growth rate of the bacterial cells having the plasmids bearing antibiotic resistant gene, their growth rate, it is going to slow down. So the susceptible bacterial cell, it is going to outnumber the bacterial cell having the antibiotic resistant gene. So in the environment, when there is no presence of the antibiotic, at that time, the number of susceptible bacterial cells, they will be in a higher number than the bacterial cell which is having the antibiotic resistant gene. That it is called as the fitness cost. So, as there is again incoming of the antibiotic into the environment, at that time what is going to happen? The bacterial cell which is bearing the antibiotic resistant gene, that bacterial cell, now they are going to outnumber the susceptible one. So in this way, okay, so in this way, whenever there is, okay, whenever there is a presence of antibiotic into the medium, antibiotic containing bacterial cell, they are going to outnumber. And when there is no presence of the antibiotic, the susceptible bacterial cells, they are going to outnumber the antibiotic resistance bacteria. Okay, so this it is going to happen when there is a presence or absence of the antibiotic into the medium or the environment. Next one, what is going to happen? The resistant gene. Okay, the resistant gene, it is going to be transferred. Okay, it is going to be transferred to the bacterial chromosome. Or you may call it as an chromosomal DNA. That is, here suppose it is the bacterial chromosome, here it is a presence of the plasmid. Plasmid, it is bearing the antibiotic resistant gene, and this antibiotic resistant gene, now it is going to be transferred to the chromosomal DNA, and the plasmid, it is going to be eliminated from the bacterial cell, so that the bacterial cell, it is going to retain the antibiotic resistant gene. And in this way, as the bacterial cell, it is going to grow, the progeny, it is getting the antibiotic resistant gene, and in this way there is a maintaining of the antibiotic resistant gene into the bacterial cell. Next, what can happen? There may be the compensatory mutations. Okay, there may be what? There may be the compensatory mutations. Compensatory mutations means what? Here, suppose here it is a plasmid. This plasmid, it is bearing an antibiotic resistant gene. Suppose we will call it as an, it is for the beta lactamase. Okay, it is for the beta lactamase. And here, whenever you say whenever there is a presence of the antibiotic resistant gene into the bacterial cell, actually a metabolic pathway, it has been inserted into the bacterial cell. Okay, so here it is the enzyme, okay, beta lactamase, it is an enzyme, means the pathway for the synthesis of the beta lactamase, it has been inserted into the bacterial cell. So here what has to be done, this, okay, the energy, it is going to be there for the synthesis of the beta lactamase enzyme. So here there will be the mutation into the beta lactamase gene. There will be the mutation into the beta lactamase gene. So here, when there is no presence of the antibiotic into the environment, okay, there will be the mutation into this antibiotic resistant gene, so that the bacterial cell, okay, the bacterial cell, now it can grow faster with the susceptible one. But as soon as there is an incoming of the antibiotic into the environment, at that time there will be the reversion. Okay, there will be the reversion into this mutation, and the antibiotic resistant gene, again it is going to be expressed, again it is going to give you the functional product, that is, there will be the synthesis of the beta lactamase. Okay, we have taken beta lactamase as an example. Okay, this beta lactamase gene, it is an example encoded by the gene, that it is called as an BLA. Okay, so this beta lactamase, okay, this beta lactamase gene, okay, beta lactamase gene, it is going to be mutated when there is no presence of the antibiotic into the medium. That mutation, it will be called as an compensatory mutation, and there will be the reversion into this gene when there is incoming of the antibiotic into the environment. Okay, so I think you may have understood the role of the plasmids into the emergence of the antibiotic resistance. If you have any doubt, if you have any comment, you can write down into the comment box, or you can personally mail me on the mail ID given into the description box. If you have liked my video, please subscribe my channel and also share my videos with your friends, so that the knowledge, it is going to spread. Thank you.